meant for an adult audience. LoveLine may contain sexually oriented content. Listener discretion is advised.
LoveLine with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
Hey, everybody, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam, that's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Dr. Drew, board-certified physician, addiction medicine specialist. I was talking to Drew about bad people before the show started, and I just thought, you know this guy. Oh, first off, happy Cinco de Mayo.
Oh, happy.
I'm going to guess Mexico's going to celebrate by eating a very special dish. This one might have beef and cheese and
rice.
Maybe finish off some rice and some beans. Yeah?
Special.
Once a year. Once a year. And maybe a little corn tortilla. Ooh. Yeah. Not a lot of culinary range, chess people.
I saw Chris's brother today.
Really?
Carbon copy of Chris.
Really?
Twice his height.
Really?
Yeah.
Engineer Chris's brother. Where'd you see him?
At Starbucks.
Oh, yeah.
By the hospital.
Oh, Drew went in there. Cinco de Mayo, yeah.
Yeah.
Trying to get yourself a little freebie on the grande latte, huh?
No go.
No go.
Yeah.
Yeah, let me tell you. I got a couple things to say. First off, this whole corporate world thing, you don't get squat anymore. There used to be a day. First off, all you needed was a roll of 20s in your pocket. You get anywhere. You know what I mean? I'm thinking about, like, Frank Sinatra and Dean Martin. You know, I'm thinking about those days.
Their life.
When it's like, yeah, you go in, like, how long's it? Well, the maitre d' says, you know, we got about a 45-minute wait. 45-minute wait. Maybe this will shorten the wait. I got down to about 20 minutes. Peel off another 20. Here you go. You know, pulling the table out. You know, now, and this is our, everything's corporate. There's right. Nobody can do anything. And Drew and I do this all the time. We meet guys, and it's like, what do you do? Oh, I'm a manager over at Electronic City. I run the whole play. Oh, you do? Because I'm looking at big screens. Oh, well, come on down. You go down and talk to the guy. He can't do anything. It's not his store.
Right.
He's just a worker ant.
Right.
And, engineer Chris's brother, fine. That, you know what that's good for? Zip. There's nothing. He could manage the Starbucks.
He does.
All right, he manages a Starbucks. He gets your brother manages a Starbucks?
Yep. That's correct.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is he younger than you?
Yeah.
Wow, that's sad.
I asked a subtle question.
Wow.
I asked a subtle question too. I go, do you live with Chris?
No.
I did.
Oh yeah, does he?
But
living at home?
Yeah.
He's living at home.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. Shut your mic. Now listen. What was I saying, Drew? Point is, guy could own the store. Can't do anything for you anymore.
Right, because it's
nobody can cut you a deal. Nobody do anything. Used to be, hey, you know, this guy runs. Yeah, he has a sofa outlet. He'd give you a sofa if you wanted to. Just come in, just hand you one. Hey, come around the back. I'll throw one out the back. Hey, there's nothing. So it doesn't matter who you know anymore. It doesn't get you anything.
You know what really still works is a Burger Continental in Pasadena.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
You know people there?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, so
it's embarrassing.
But it's not a chain.
No, but that's the point.
That's
owned by a family, and
that's it. There's a handful of mom and pop places left where you can go over there, and a guy can just throw you a handful of this or a couple of those.
But he does it with everybody too.
It's no good now. You could know the guy who manages the Home Depot that would not be good for one free 3/4-inch wood screw worth 3 cents. It gets you nothing.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It's not worth networking anymore. You used to network. Like, hey, you know this guy? I know this guy. Hey, he'll get you in over it. No, none of that anymore. Nothing anyone can do about anything. It's one big corporate thing. And all the guy, Chris's brother, worthless. He's dead to me, by the way. He's worthless. It's not good for anything. You go in there, probably pay a little extra. Here's a good thing about like Starbucks. You know a guy? He can get you a coffee for $8. All these other suckers are paying like $9.50 for it. Fantastic. That's a whole 12 ounces. All right. Now, what was I going to say? Oh, yeah. Here's what I was going to say.
Yeah.
Drew, new twist on hitting the mic. You scraped it with your ring tonight. Playing it like that wooden fish. Cinco de Mayo, very exciting. Mm-hmm. They caught this guy who phoned in basically the terrorist threat in the West Side.
Really?
Remember this?
Yeah.
Last week?
Oh, my God.
It's a big deal. Last week out here, out in the West Side, by Westwood, UCLA, and all that area. Somebody said, phoned something in, I think it was in through Canada or something, where there's going to be terrorist activity. By the way, this costs people a lot of money.
That's the point. That's why it's illegal.
Yeah. Well, it also takes a certain toll emotionally.
Yeah.
But you waste a lot of time, a lot of energy on it. Here's the thing. Here's what the guy did. His girlfriend, he was a Middle Eastern cat. He was living in Canada, traveling somewhere on the East Coast. He was going through Montana or something from Canada. Anyway, Middle Eastern guy had pissed off at his girlfriend because she owed him a few bucks. So thought it would be a good way to get back at her by phoning in a threat using her name. And her new boyfriend's name. So,
fantastic.
You know, the feds would show up at their place, guns drawn. Here's my thing on this guy. I want him blown up. I want him dead. I have like zero tolerance policy for this kind of stuff. You know, we have zero tolerance for like, oh, look, doesn't matter if you get caught with one joint or a metric ton of marijuana. We got zero tolerance. How about you, in this climate, by the way, in this climate, you calling in from Canada, picking specific targets in the west side of Los Angeles because you PO'd at the old lady. Yeah, this will show her. This guy, by the way, the reason they caught her, and this is another reason I want this guy. I just want an M80 put up his ass and just blow him up in the town square. He's got problems because he tried to embezzled some money from a job, and his papers are, you know, he's here illegally. His papers have lapsed. Away. And by the way, I like this kind of a-hole. Even though he's already sort of a fugitive, he's still got enough time to phone in a few threats and stuff and sort of, like, rekindle the fugitive flame, you know? Mm-hmm. And this is what our, by the way, our INS, it's like the INS scheduled a meeting with him, but he never showed up. You know, this is our policy. It's like we get some guy from the Middle East. His visa's expired. He's got some trouble. He's got some legal problems. Yeah.
Come on.
Hey, Nazif, could you come by and drop in? We'd like to talk to you. Oh, gee, wonder where he is.
He
must have left the country. Well, we don't have the resources to go look for him. Yeah. But we got the resources to get my buddy Ray with the parking tickets out of his mom's apartment 10 years ago. Gonna call a guy in for me. So the guy, you know, the guy takes it on the lamb, and then he phones this one in. Now what's it? What do we got to do with the guy? Can we just put him in a goddamn cannon and fire him toward the Middle East? Hope he makes it there. You know what I mean? How much resources? How much time? I don't know about the policy about wanting to have sit down with people that obviously are gonna flee. It's like look. Hey, it looks like you've been shoplifting. Yeah, your pants are filled with power tools and other valuables from our store. Let's say 2 weeks from today. What's today? Thursday? Thursday, good for you about noon? Should come back, and we'll have a little sit-down, okay? A word of honor, though. I'll meet you here. All right? All right. Okay, have a good day. Yeah. Wait, think the guy's going to show up, or might he just take off? Jesus Christ, what are we doing in this country? And what are we going to do with guys like this? And what can we do with them?
The problem is you're by painting this guy as Middle Easterner, then you trigger everybody's spidey senses. I mean, he could be Jordanian, he could be Saudi Arabian, he could be a lot of different things.
He was one of the countries. Well, no, it gave credence to his accusations and allegations because he had the accent, because he had the name. It made sense to the authorities. It wasn't some teenage kid laughing from Arkansas. Go, yeah, I'm gonna do that.
Yeah, but he said he was the girlfriend or something.
She was of that descent as well.
I see.
And so was her new boyfriend or something, evidently.
But the point is that the guy's a criminal. That's what this is about.
Hey, what do you think?
Criminal with the right credentials.
What do you think I'm saying?
Well, I want to not have people not hear what you're saying because they react to you painting it with a broad brush about the Middle Easterners. That's all. I'm trying to help you.
Oh, shut up. Stop pussing out on everything, Drew. What are you talking about? I want this guy destroyed.
Fine.
No, not all right.
What do you think I'm saying? I'm being such a paranoid puss.
I'm just thinking how people will hear these things.
Who cares what people think? Mm. Are stoners who listen to this crappy show? I don't give an ass.
But then you don't care that your message gets heard. I'm trying to make it so people don't get defensive about what you're saying.
I'm not... I said the guy was Middle Eastern, and he ratted out on his girlfriend.
I know what you're saying. I'm just thinking about how people react to this.
I don't care how people react to it. What am I saying?
You're saying that a guy that's a criminal should be, there should be zero tolerance for criminal behavior of this type, particularly at this time.
Yes.
Period. That's all. Independent of his ethnicity or where he's from or whatever. Just that feeds into the sort of the craziness about all this.
All right, quiet down. Courtney, stop being such a puss.
Stop being a puss.
Right. Oh, as soon as we get off the air, you know I'm right.
No.
Ah, please. Who cares? You idiots. Drew, too. Two-faced.
Courtney.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's up?
Hey, what's up? I guess to ask my question now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm not real good at this. I'm sorry. I'm kind of nervous.
That's all right.
We like listening to that accent out here, though, so go ahead.
Okay. my question is, and I don't know, I'm 20, and my boyfriend's 26, and in the past, which not anymore, but in the past, he told me, and like, I know him around town or whatever, and my friends know him, that when he graduated, that he's done a lot of drugs. And I think, like, cocaine and stuff like that, and, like, when he was younger, you know, and when he used to, like, be a player, I guess you could say, or whatever. Anyways, my question is that for some reason, and I know I'm young, I know I'm 20, but for some reason I'm really sexually active, like, not with, like, a bunch of guys, but since I've dated him, I've been really sexually active.
Well,
he's not. And he, I mean, when he drinks or something, that's when you want to do it, or, you know, something like that, or make love. But that seems like that's the only time. And I'll do.
All right. Shut up.
Okay,
shut up. That's all right.
I'm sorry.
Just give a quick tip to everybody. When people get nervous, they talk way too much, too fast. And it makes sense. But on the other hand,
disturb Adam from his slumber.
Jesus.
Come on now.
Okay. Now, let me try to get a few questions in.
Okay.
What are you actually doing? How often?
Yeah.
Like, okay. I mean, sometimes not even during, probably maybe. I mean, it all depends. We might do it twice in 1 week and then three more weeks.
Okay, there you go. Fine. Stop. Relax. Okay. Just give us just the facts, ma'am. Okay?
That's right, ma'am.
What are you good for? What do you want?
I don't understand.
How often would you like to have sex?
At least 3 or 4 times a week.
Okay, stop. Right. Just answer the question.
They're not too far off.
No. Yeah. Well, he sometimes lets it go for 3 weeks and she freaks out.
Oh, I couldn't get through all that.
Yeah.
I don't freak out, really. He says that he'll go, oh, baby, it's not you, you know. And say, I recently lost my father, and I kind of, like, I'm not fat. I mean, I weigh about 145, but I guess I weighed a little bit less. And I've recently lost my father, and when I did that, they put me on Paxil, which made me gain a little bit of weight. And now I started back losing it.
Didn't the Paxil shut you down sexually a little bit?
No, that's the thing.
All right, relax. Mm-hmm. Is your boyfriend on any medication?
No, he's not on any medication.
But does he do any, you said he did some drugs?
Yeah.
And he's not doing anything now?
No, he's not doing anything at all.
That doesn't make sense.
Well, what drugs?
Sir, go ahead.
What drugs? Sir, Adam.
Yeah. Sorry.
Sorry.
That's all right.
He did cocaine and he drank a lot. He took Xanaxes and stuff like that. Like,
say cocaine again.
Yeah, cocaine is a great drug for you.
Say cocaine.
Huh?
What drugs did he do?
He said he did cocaine and, like, he took
pills. Yeah, I love that.
Probably everything. No, y'all are making fun of me.
No, Drew is.
No, he's true. Fine.
He loves the Middle Easterns. He hates the kinfolk from Georgia.
All right, Courtney, here's the deal. This may just be his sort of normal rhythm. He's not way off in terms of what some guys are.
Yeah.
Now, it's disturbing that he used to be sort of super sexually active. He might even have been an addict and maybe even a sex addict.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things that happens when people are sort of head towards sexual compulsion is that they'll go through periods of deprivation where they're sort of not into it. But this doesn't sound like that particularly either. Yeah, it's disturbing that he only wants to have sex when he's using drugs or alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
Frankly, I'll be honest with you.
I don't like him.
Yeah, not a great guy to be in a relationship with, bottom line.
No.
And
but here's, honestly, by your twang, we've decided you've done a horrible job picking a guy. Let me
match your number, though, probably.
Yeah, let me say this. Sometimes we base these guys' partners on how the guy actually is, and then other times we base them on the type of person...
that she is.
That the person would pick.
Right, right.
And sometimes when I talk to Courtney, what the hell
Courtney.
Was she? Yeah, Courtney over here, I just see somebody who's She lost her dad. She's beating herself up because she put on a couple of pounds.
Super codependent.
And I feel like I don't like the guy she's attracted to.
Right. An addict. Guy's an addict.
Even if he wasn't, I don't like that guy.
And he's not. She is expressing very specific needs, and he's not willing to respond to that.
Here's the deal, all you 20-year-old broads, even the ones that got an extra couple of pounds on you. You can get what you want out there.
Easily.
It's buyer's market. You can find what you need.
Or seller's market in this case.
It's a seller's market. Yeah. You got a fresh load of poontang just got off, just right from the docks. We just loaded
this net opened up and all.
Just unloaded it off the cargo net. Yeah, it's all on the deck now.
Like a Bubba Gump.
That's right.
Deck.
That's right.
Just poured out on the deck. There.
For me, all I got was the license plate and the one cod just flopping around there. And like an old,
after
like a boot.
Months of trolling.
Like a boot.
Months,
yeah.
Years of trolling.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah.
All right. So, go find a decent guy.
Yeah.
Yeah?
I'm afraid so. Sorry, but we got to sort of tell you what our honest assessment is.
Going. Alex?
Hey, what's up, fellas?
You're 15?
Yeah.
What's happening?
I was diagnosed with throat cancer a few months ago.
Throat cancer? Mm. What kind?
Yes. I don't know. It was on my voice box. It was some long name. I can't remember what it was.
Now, wait a minute. When you get laryngeal cancer, they take your voice box off or they give you x-ray treatments.
They gave me laser surgery to treat it.
Okay.
I had to go down to St. Louis.
Did that take care of it?
Yeah, it took care of it.
Wow, that is rare in your age.
Yeah.
Do you smoke a lot of cigarettes or pot?
Yeah, I smoked a lot of pot. That was the question.
Well, there you go. There you go.
Do you think that could have caused it?
Cancer in 2 years of smoking pot.
You wouldn't think so, but here he is doing something. You know what I mean?
Well,
it's not typical, that's for sure. But you got to stop all that. You got to stop all that.
Yeah, I stopped after.
I mean, that's the nuttiness of that's like somebody on a breathing machine. You smoking cigarettes because they're in emphysema.
See it all the time.
Yeah.
Hey, Alex.
Yeah.
Well, let me ask you how this stuff works, Drew. Well, I'm bracing myself for being let down with your answer. Obviously, the guy has a predisposition for this stuff or he's not going to get it. I know doctors, like you do with the gynecomastia thing. Well, that's from Berlin. No, that's another predisposition. But there's certain things that can aggravate it or kickstart it or activate it or whatever you want to call it.
I mean, you can get as wild as you want with it.
Obviously, pot isn't going to give the guy cancer when everyone else smokes pot and doesn't get it.
Listen, just every illness, Adam, is an interaction between the gene and the environment. Everyone. So to say it's a predisposition is saying, well, that's all illness.
Yeah, but the gene is the predominant one. If it's the environment, that takes, you know, many, many years, depending on what the environment is. I mean, if you're working in a coal mine, maybe you can get some black lung in 10 years. Mm-hmm. But you're smoking weed in high school, you got many, many years. Unless the gene is going to have to outweigh the environment.
Or serendipity prevails. I mean, there's a probability equation of when that gene-environment interaction is going to develop.
What I'm asking is, and maybe there's no answer to it, obviously him smoking pot didn't help.
Right.
It obviously also didn't cause it.
Right.
Doesn't make sense for him to smoke any more pot.
Right.
If he never smoked pot,
yeah,
this probably would have showed up at some point.
Hard to say, probably.
And unless there's some things that sort of hover, and do we know enough to know? Like,
no.
Something like this hover around, and just a little bit of pop is enough just to sort of the straw that broke the camel's back? I don't think it works that way, does it? Or does anyone know?
Nobody knows for sure, but it's a probability equation. You put a carcinogen in, and it's the number of hits versus when the gene expresses, when the cancer expresses.
Yeah, all I know
is like, it's like shooting ping pong balls at a wall. You know what I mean? It's like thousands of them get there, and finally one pow pops through.
Here's all I'm saying. Here's all I got to say. As somebody brought this. I'm all I can think of genetics anymore. That's all. That's why I need some of your sperm.
Yeah. Yeah, you do.
I'm a smart kid.
Yeah.
I get that. You got a nice jawline. Look at work. I got those. What color are those?
Bad eyes. Bad
yeah.
Eyes.
Okay. We don't need any of that. Chris. What?
Yeah.
And all right, I'm going to see if I can find Stryker. He left the building. Yeah. Anne has a very handsome husband that has a pretty strong seed, although I'm not sure about the kid's work ethic. But I could use a little of a seed. So if you got sometimes a little left on the sleeve or I'm not telling you how to. Anyway.
It's getting weird. Actually.
It's getting weird. Okay. Here's my point. Here's all I said. I'm sitting in my office today, and one of my buddies, Dave, he says, he laments out loud. He says, I've been working out. I've been going to the gym for 1 year now. It's been 1 year. I've been working out, with hitting the weights every day for a year. I look about the same. What's going on? I can't believe this. I said, look, I said, Dave, look at it this way. Our buddy Tony in the next office has bigger, nicer, more well-defined calves than any professional tennis player on the circuit currently. He does nothing. Why? Why? Well, that's why.
James.
That's it. And I just started thinking about that. We live in this society where it's like, oh, where'd you get that from? Well, I used to dance when I was, oh, Tony, that's where you got this wonderful catch. Oh, what happened to him? Well, he shouldn't, you know, because he was a bike messenger, so he sucked up a lot of on, and that's where it got him. He got the esophageal cancer. And no, it's just, the environment's not going to help, but man, if you're getting something, you're getting something.
Yeah.
And if your body ain't going to handle it, go to the gym all you want, knock yourself out. No one ever think you went one day. Yes? Okay. All right. Drew, you had something to say.
Tony Barbieri, is that his
name? Yeah.
That's his cousin. He's a producer at the Dennis Miller Show.
Really? I had no idea.
Which I'm on that show tonight.
You're doing Dennis Miller tonight?
I did it yesterday.
How was that?
Good. He may come up here.
Dennis?
Yeah.
No.
His son is a huge fan.
It's still not going to happen.
Well, his son may come up.
Drew, you shot a movie with 13 people so far.
One.
We got Jack Osborne from the movie, who was probably scheduled to come on anyway.
That's right. His mom made him come.
All right, Alex.
Yeah.
Here's the thing, buddy boy. I don't think the pot smoking gave you cancer.
Well,
but
every time I did it, my throat got more hoarse. Time I did it. And then I went to the doctor, and then that's how they discovered it.
Here's what's clear. You can never do it again.
What did they say? Yeah, you got to start eating brownies, dude. What did... It's the pot smoker's laugh that left your throat up. Hey, Alex?
Yeah?
What did the doctor who treated you say about the throat cancer and the marijuana?
He didn't talk.
I didn't tell him I smoked marijuana.
Didn't give him the heads up, huh?
I love that about
him. I love that, too. And by the way, at a certain point, can't you just scrape a burnout's throat for resins? I mean, hey, there's nothing there. Don't smell like anything. No, nothing. And by the way, don't start... And if this caused it, wouldn't that be the first question you asked?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So listen, buddy. No more pot smoking for you.
Yeah.
That's it.
Did you fart again?
No. I may have moved around a little, which may have unlodged it from my chair from last night.
No, I think it's just been lost in that forest you've got going down there.
Oh, I let a nice one go on the, you know, on way the way in. Home. No, on the way home.
Oh, no, God.
Oh, man, it was great.
That's after unloading here for an hour and a half.
Let me tell you something about you jive turkeys out there in your big SUVs. Not only are you supporting Al-Qaeda, but you cannot enjoy your own gas when you drive around in a blimp hangar. You know, you got 750 cubic
that
feet of space.
That is the reason not
there.
To drive the SUV. Thank you.
You
finally a reason.
Yeah, it's like driving a concert hall down the street. You blow some gas, it just blows behind you, gets caught in some vortex, goes back to the 17th row of your seating. You know, it's no good. You blow wind in a small two-seater like me, oh.
I appreciate it.
Oh, you get 6-7 off-ramps enjoyment off of that,
Let's
baby.
Let's do a tease with Jessica before we go to break.
All right. Jessica?
Yeah.
What's happening, baby? What's your question?
Well, whenever I get clitoral stimulation,
mm-hmm.
either orally or by masturbation, I actually basically turn into Thumper the Rabbit from Bambi.
Perfect. Hold on. If that leg gets going, like when you scratch a dog's ass. Good times. All right, we'll take a quick break. We'll get back with Jessica after this. Hey, yo, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Dr. Drew, Borchetta, Santa, Baba, Baya, Baba, Baba, Baya, Jay Moore coming in here tomorrow night.
I believe you are the only radio host in the country that routinely breaks into gibberish.
Not that you. No, that's not gibberish. That's American Indian. Come on.
Well, you have American Indian gibberish. You have strip show stripper club gibberish. You have talk show gibberish. You have radio gibberish.
Anything but talk.
Yeah, anything but actually speak English.
Yeah, yeah. Now they're not. They're not that different. American Indian gibberish is
Is a whole talk show host gibberish.
Chris over here is a little, still living at home. His mom's like, oh, blah. And Chris's like, well, so I'm a lot. And the mom's like, why don't you get the also?
And then there's the stripper, strip club DJ gibberish.
Well, I need the music for that. I can't, you know, I can't just get into it.
Let's all drink coffee while we wait for that to pet it.
All right.
It up.
All right, let's go to the phones here.
Oh, Anderson let us down.
Hey, Rob. Wait a minute, it's the wrong guy. Come here. Give it to me again. Hey, everybody, Cheryl coming to Live Low. Cheryl, Live Low. I'll tell you, Miss Man Lunch coming in to serve a little. I'm a fat guy with a fanny pack.
And I believe there's even a Minka gibberish, if I remember right.
No, I don't have any.
Yeah, think about it.
No, I don't.
When she came and talked to you at the strip club?
Yeah, what was her what was her thing?
Number one, Asian big boob queen.
She can't even open her mouth. Been ruined by penis. Big boob queen.
But remember,
beaches ain't. But
well, that's not gibberish. That's not gibberish. But then when she stilettoed your nuts or something, and
no, that's Mexican gibberish.
That's Mexican gibberish.
Yeah. Hey.
Who?
You want to hear my three mijos?
Yeah.
I'm going to do my three mijos
for Cinco de Mayo.
For honor of Cinco de Mayo. I don't know how I work this out, but it always delights the boys at the office. Mijo, by the way, Engineer Chris will tell you, that's what the Mexican moms call their kids.
You have Mexican dad,
they call though. They call their sons.
You have Mexican dad, though, right?
Yeah.
You have Italian mom.
Whatever.
Right.
Same difference. Here's the point. They call their sons mijo. I don't think they call the girls. Maybe they call them mija. Mija. But mijo. I don't know. What's it? Son or lover or sweet pea or whatever it is.
Whatever.
Term of endearment. So here's the three mijos.
Okay.
This is Chris's mom. She's coming home. Yeah, just pretend she's Mexican.
Right. It's my mom, yeah.
Yeah. She's come home from a day of shopping. It's just starting to get dark. She thinks Chris is home. So the first mijo, she comes through the door.
She's got bad
groceries.
Yeah.
She wants some help. She's announcing that she's come home. So now, this number one mijo comes through the door. Mijo! Okay, that's I'm home mijo, right?
Yeah.
Now, what's going on? It's dark. The lights haven't been turned on.
He should be home.
I saw his donkey parked out in the driveway, but he's not here.
Uh-oh.
And now it's confusion.
Yeah.
Mijo? That's the second mijo. Third one walks into the room. Now, just a shot from behind him, he's swinging.
Oh.
He's hung himself. He's obviously, he couldn't put up with the pain, humiliation. So it's a shot of her with the feet swinging in front of her,
and?
Holding the groceries. Drops the groceries. Eggs crack on the ground. Third one. Mijo! Yeah. Those are all three.
That's great.
That's three. Uh-huh. First one's I'm home. Second one is where are you? Third is, just breaking down. Slow motion, eggs
mijo.
Cracking on the ground.
There's
a little mijo for Cinco de Mayo.
Thumper.
Jessica.
Yes. Hi.
All right. So you're 17.
Yes.
Whenever
I get clitoral stimulation, mm-hmm. I like freak out.
You freak out.
Mm-hmm.
It's uncomfortable.
I don't know how to explain it. It's like someone pulling on a nerve or something. Like I can't handle it, and I make them stop.
It's like somebody like rubbing their finger on the top roof of your mouth, kind of feeling.
Well, worse than that. Like maybe scratching your fingernails down a chalkboard.
Again, is there a male, 17-year-old male on Earth that could describe his penis being stimulated that way?
Mm-mm.
I don't care if he's had a spinal cord injury.
Mm-mm.
There is not a male on Earth that could describe things that way.
Mm-mm.
Do you have orgasms?
No, I've never had an orgasm.
Have you ever had intercourse?
Yes.
And do you feel close to orgasm with that or no?
No, not at all.
Okay. Is it overwhelming? Is everything, yeah. Every time someone stimulates you, is it overwhelming?
Yeah, I mean, they try, and then I'm like, okay, you have to stop.
Do you feel sexual? Do you get aroused?
Yeah, I do, but it's just, I can't handle it. I don't know if I should just try to handle it anyway, but...
No, like, you should just kind of lay off for a while. This biology will kind of catch up with time. This is what people do not talk about. That women have sort of each woman is different, but there's sort of an age which they kind of come online with this. Their biology sort of catches up with
them. Yep, 63. That's the
average.
For
some, it's 45, but I think Jessica's got to be at least 22 or so.
All right. Also, you're somebody. Let me say this.
Mijo.
Jessica is like a car that is finely tuned,
it's winding
like a
out.
Race car.
Yeah.
And you know what? I'm going to go a step further. It's like a race motorcycle. Mm-hmm. If you've ever ridden a race motorcycle, it's hard to keep the front end on the ground. I mean, the front wheel comes off the ground. It's scary and difficult to drive. Once you master it, once you get used to it, take a few practice laps, you can get around the track in record time. She has the potential for this, but is having trouble harnessing her horsepower.
Mm.
She obviously, everything's hooked up. Huh? Maybe she was molested?
No. I think maybe it needs a more mature hormonal environment kind of thing. The brain and the hormones need to hook all up.
Ironically, Drew, you could see her through this.
Ironically enough.
I mean, I'm a seasoned, passionate man
here's
of your age. You'd work this out.
Every male, that's what's flashing through their mind. No problem.
Yeah, but this...
But the reality is, probably not.
A 17-year-old guy... working on her is like a worthless. Retarded monkey with an Etch-a-Sketch.
A retarded monkey on that motorcycle.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it's a disaster. Except for that, the monkey would kill himself on the motorcycle.
She's got to keep figuring herself out, but relax. Don't be in a hurry to have sex. Well, why? Why would you, Jessica? It doesn't do anything for you.
And plus, it's everything is, you know, it's an explanation of like slow down.
Yeah,
if you're hurting
you
me.
Feel,
be careful.
You feel flawed and less than. And the guy's working on you like a Rubik's cube. And look, it's your biology. It'll catch up. It's meant to come on when it comes on.
You think Chris knows what a Rubik's cube is?
Yeah, he says yes.
I
used to have one.
You did?
Yeah, I used to have one.
Yeah. What happened? He ate it.
Probably.
Yeah. You still got it? Well, you got to have it.
Chris, you're sweetbread.
Sweetbread.
Yeah.
What is sweetbread?
What do you mean, what is sweetbread? Oh. Yeah, what is sweetbread?
Sweetbread, I don't know.
Okay. How about caviar?
Yeah. That was yesterday.
What is that? Caviar.
Fish eggs.
Okay.
There you go.
Sweetbread.
Leave the kid alone. What is that, stomach? It's his intestine? What is it? It's not brain.
And pancreas.
All right. It's a part you should be tossing out.
One of the many, yeah.
Whatever.
And it's like, how do we get people to eat this? Let's call it stomach stuff. So how about sweetbread? Yeah. Oh, all right. That'll get just enough people confused enough on the menu. Should be enough stoners to order that. Hey, what do you want? Hey, what about the sweetbread? Huh? Count me in. How can you go wrong with sweetbread? Oh, it's just a lining of a stomach. Pancreas. It's delightful. Amy?
Yes.
You're 22?
Yes.
What's the matter?
Well, when I went down with my boyfriend, right, we used flavored condoms.
Mm-hmm.
And
ooh, sweetbread flavored. Talk to the Trojan people about that.
I will bring that up tomorrow morning, first thing.
Menudo condoms? Yeah,
it's got to be
Cinco de Mayo.
Yeah, there's got to be.
I'm just thinking of stomach related, you know, foods. Go ahead.
There's got to be a catchy name for that Menudo condom, too.
I've done it three times.
Cinco de Gizzo.
Magnum Menudos.
Go ahead, David.
After the first one, I think like 3 or 4 days later, I got sick.
After you exposed yourself to the condoms?
Yeah.
What do you mean you got sick?
It's like I was running like 103 temperature.
Right. Three or 4 days later, you got sick. So what?
I don't know if I'm allergic to them or.
No, Amy, please.
I'm just
primitive
getting rid
man
of her
here. She's 22.
Primitive Mija.
Primitive Mija. It's like the volcano erupted, and I'd walk from right to left across the street. I made it happen.
Right.
Amy,
3 or 4 days later, you got the flu.
Right.
All right.
Oh, my goodness.
All right. Well, go ahead and stop eating condoms anyway. I mean, look, if you'd actually consumed it, But she just even performed then, oral sex.
Even then. Mm-hmm. It would pass undisturbed.
Mm-hmm. All right. Let's take a break. Yeah. Chris, pop up. Look at that internet there, mijo. Find, that's your new name. Look up sweetbreads.
I'll do it. I'll go for it.
No, no. Let Chris do it. I got to talk to you in the bathroom, mister. Yeah, I want to find out what part of the intestine or pancreas or what gross part of the cow that we should have been tossing away is being consumed in that dish.
Is it even a pig? It's a lamb or something, isn't it?
I don't even know. I think it's a cow.
The cow, yeah.
All right. You got it, Chris?
Yeah, I'm looking at it.
All right, buddy.
What's it say? We can't wait. All right, forget it.
It's still loading up.
All right, buddy. He's just looking for it. All right, buddy. Well, take a quick break. We'll be right back. Hey, everybody. It's Loveline. That's Dr. Drew. Happy Cinco de Mayo, everybody. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Drew over there looking up sweetbreads, trying to figure out what sickening part of a cow's stomach is involved with that culinary disaster.
I'll have it.
Drew will have it. Engineer Chris found recipes for sweetened bread. That's all right, buddy. I would have done the same thing. I didn't know it was one word. Drew's hip. He's navigating his way through the internet. Jay Moore, the very funny Jay Moore, will be in here on Thursday. Andy Richter coming in, maybe, next week. Lost Prophets. Steve-O and Chris Pontius are going to be in here also next week. Newfound Glory the week after that. Look out, everybody. All right, nice. Drew, I'm going back to the phones. What do you say?
You want me to try to
find... I don't need you. You do your work over there. Hey, Shannon?
Yeah?
You're 20?
Yeah. Hey, guys. How are you doing?
What's up?
Well, okay. I have a question. I'm really paranoid.
Mm-hmm.
And I was wondering if it was because, like, I've been told I have brain damage.
Mm-hmm.
I had a lot of concussions, probably between the ages of 15 and 17.
How many?
Oh, probably about 6.
Hmm. And what from? Oral sex? Because guys get rough. What's that?
I played
playing hockey.
And I got in some really bad car accidents. And my psychiatrist actually gave me the test, and they said that they think that's why I got so depressed.
Do I need to talk to her?
No, I'm cool. You got some of the concussions playing hockey.
Uh-huh.
And some of the concussions in car accidents.
Mm-hmm. I had 2 really bad car accidents.
Oh, really? What happened?
Well, the one, my friend was driving, and she stopped at a red light, and...
Oh, you can't drive with women.
And she just stopped like it was a stop sign and kept going, and I just, like, all I remember is going, what are you doing? And then that's all. And
you got a concussion on that one.
Yeah, well, I broke the windshield and my side window with my forehead.
Your head. Yeah. Wow. And were you wearing a seatbelt?
No. But I learned pretty quick after that to start wearing it.
All right. So, you've been concussed many times, mm-hmm. and now you go to a psychiatrist.
Mm-hmm.
And what do they do in the test to figure out whether that's a problem or not?
Well,
whether or not there's been brain damage from the concussions?
Or you're suffering from a syndrome that is based on it.
There are neuropsychiatric testing. It's very complex. It takes a whole day to do it.
I'm guessing that wasn't the one she got.
Mm.
I'm guessing she got the one that says, do you sometimes get impatient in lines? All right. I see. What was the test? And Drew, did you find out with sweetbreads?
Yeah. It's the thymus or pancreas of a young animal, especially lamb or calf.
Ooh. Or calf. So it could be cow, but it could be lamb, especially lamb or calf.
Yeah. But young animal, thymus or pancreas.
What's a thymus?
It's a gland in the front part of your chest here.
So it's in pancreas.
It's where your T cells come from. Why I think of something as a T cell is it comes from a thymus cell.
Oh, because it starts with a T.
Yeah.
Coincidence. And then the pancreas. How much different is that? What's the difference between your pancreas and the rest of your stuff? Huh?
Chris's dad just calling it.
Uh-oh.
Oh, to bust your chops, dude.
Okay. calling it. All right, hold on a second.
Is your dad named Carlos?
Oh. I got to talk to him. Hold on a second, Drew. Where's the pancreas?
Right here.
What do you? That's is that in your stomach?
Below it, yeah.
Below it. What's it do?
creates insulin and glucagon and all the it's all the enzymes that digest your stuff, your food.
Oh, yeah. Does your food go into it, or is it pumped?
It's outside of pump stuff into the small intestine.
Oh, so it's
the duodenum.
It's like a little acid tank that pumps stuff into the hopper.
Well, it has endocrine and exocrine function. It pumps stuff into your bloodstream, insulin, mm-hmm. this kind of mm-hmm. thing, and it pumps stuff into the mm-hmm. outside your body into the small
all
intestine.
Right. All right. Anyway. There you go.
So, what was Shanna's question?
Yeah, well, she's had many concussions, and now she's paranoid, and she took a test and wants to know, and her psychiatrist said she was a candidate for this medication, I guess.
What medicine?
Oh, no, not that. I was just wondering, well, my psychiatrist told me that that's the reason why I got so depressed.
Because the head injuries?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
What test did you take?
Well, there were a lot of series of, like, MRIs and stuff like that. And then,
so it wasn't written tests.
Right, okay.
Oh, no, I'd had those, too, and they would give me, like, memory matching, and I guess
okay.
I did really
all right.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. So now what?
But, yeah, and, well, I'm just really under, like, a tremendous amount of stress, too, but I am so paranoid. Like, I think people are following me home,
uh-huh.
and I think, like, people are watching me through the windows, and, like...
Do you do any speed or anything like that?
No.
Okay, and were you paranoid before the head injuries?
Not really.
Okay, what's your question?
But like, how do I? Is that because of my like injuries?
Yes, and paranoia is something that it's a biological state, and it can be treated quite effectively.
All right.
Like, what would I have to do? Because it's like controlling my life.
Medication. It's very simple.
How come the boxers don't seem to have that paranoia? You know, people have. You know, most of this, they slow down. They become a little sort of hazy, but they're not. They're almost the opposite of paranoid.
From the punch drunk? From too much?
Yeah, just many, many blows to the head, trauma. It doesn't... I'm not an expert in it.
I suspect Shannon is more complex than just her head injuries.
That's what I'm thinking, because people seem to get depressed and they get dulled and stuff, but you don't hear about the paranoia.
No.
Okay. All right, but there's medication. Take care of it. Engineer Chris's dad is on the line. Carlos?
Yes, how do you do?
How do you do? You're the father of this fine engineer we have over here?
I am, and I'm so proud of him.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks, Dad.
He's a great kid. And I say kid, but I'm really talking about a 27-year-old. I call him kid because he's going home to your house tonight. eat your food and use your electricity.
Well, he lives with his mother.
Yeah. Oh, I
his
see.
His brother.
I see. Yeah. Here's the thing I find ironic about. Now, it's ironic that Carlos is calling in during Cinco de Mayo because you're a Hispanic gentleman. Yes, Carlos?
I am. Yes.
Yes. The boys get to they get to live at home well into their 30s, but the ladies are pregnant by 14. It doesn't make sense. You know what I'm saying?
What
it should
ladies?
Be one or the other. Like, if the girls are going to be pregnant at 15, the guy should be out of the house at 17. Yeah, it shouldn't.
Yeah.
They cut the guys too much slack.
Ah.
Yeah.
Well, their mother needs them.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah. She needs them to move out and quit eating so much.
No. What's
their
mother's
very
proud of them.
I met the whole family today in one day.
Yeah.
Well, you met the dad.
I'm meeting the dad. I met your other son.
I heard you busted him for not getting free coffee.
Well, Adam busted him, really.
Well, Drew...
I was very unassuming and polite.
Let me explain something. Today may be Cinco de Mayo, a day for the Latinos to celebrate, but Drew's half Jew, and every day is Jew Day for him. He wants something free every goddamn day. Yeah, and he's angry when he can't. He thinks he's kidding around, but he's not. He really wants something free every day.
I don't get a free cup of coffee when I get in there.
See? See how that works?
Yeah. You should kick him out of your old house. Now, what's the deal? You guys got divorced, and you're off on your own?
Well, sort of. I've got a dog.
You got a dog. And are you living in an apartment?
No, I have my own home.
Oh, okay.
In Monrovia?
Yes, I do.
And what business are you in?
Law enforcement. I work for one of the police departments here in the city.
Ooh. Uh-oh. Now, are you a cop?
I am.
You're
in Monrovia?
No, not in Monrovia.
No, it's too bad, because Drew's hoping he'd get pulled over. By
I go up there all the time. We kids go to the slot car shop there, and we eat at Cafe del Opera. It's like,
yeah, now, where...
That's why I have two great kids.
What's your beat, Carlos? Where can we speed?
All of it, Los Angeles.
Okay.
Oh, my goodness.
All right. And you drive a cruiser? You're out on the street?
Oh, no. I'm a lieutenant in the office.
Oh, okay.
Chris will get us his card.
Yeah, we need his card. As a matter of fact, I want his tin.
Great.
You got an extra badge, Carlos?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
Because I want to actually flash a tin if I get pulled over next time.
Yeah. Any tin won't do.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I got to work that.
That's my son.
Well, you gotta, oh, really? Oh, you've tried to...
They've gotten tickets. Yeah.
You tried to play that my dad's Officer Perez card many times.
Yeah,
yes,
but it doesn't help.
Doesn't work.
Nope.
Yeah.
It doesn't work.
All right, buddy. We got to take a break. Thanks for calling in.
Okay, great. Take I'll care
start,
of my son now.
I treat him as like my son. Yeah. Empty the garbage.
Thanks for calling, Dad.
God bless him. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Hey, everybody. LoveLine. Amanda, that's Dr. Drew over there. Phone number 1-800-LZ-191. Yeah. All right. Well, Engineer Chris's dad phoning in.
How'd he get through? Did you find out?
Yeah.
He called the main line.
He did. He got in.
Get through.
Well, he's a bad MF-er. He's a cop. He's got his own, he doesn't play by the book.
Own rules.
He plays by his own rules. And it's a pain, you know, for Chris because he plays by his own rules, you know, out on the street with the perps and everything, but even when they're at home just playing Chinese checkers or Stratego, he'll just go, what he'll do is he'll go, like if you try to play cards with Chris's dad, he'll just walk around the table, look at your hand, and then walk back down and sit down.
Those are his rules.
That's how he plays.
Yeah,
he plays by his own rules.
His rules. Doesn't matter what your rules are. Doesn't matter what anybody else's rules are. They're his rules.
I've been bowling with the man before. He gives himself a strike, even if he doesn't pick up the spare. You know,
even if he doesn't pick up the ball.
He leaves 6-7 pins standing, just get nice X. He bowled 9 perfect games.
No, he goes, I don't feel like bowling the ball this time.
Yeah.
Strike.
Plays by his own rule. That's right. He doesn't even go bowling. He just declares himself the winner.
Well, on some days.
Plays by his own rules. That's all right. And Chris plays by his mom's rules. All right, buddy. You got to get out of that house now. You can't. How are you going to cruise chicks from your mom's house?
Dude, you can give me money.
You need money?
Yeah.
I'll give you some money. All right. How much do you need?
I don't know.
Okay, we got to
think about looking.
I was building a new big house. You can get a spare room.
I'll put you up there. I need a house boy.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Chris.
Because summer's coming up. It's hot. I'm going to need like refills of my Arnie Palmers and stuff like that.
You know, no telling what it might require you to do.
Mm. You know, well,
some weird stuff goes down in his house.
Yeah, and of course we sign a confidentiality agreement too, because I don't need this hitting the tabloids. Mary?
Hi.
You're 21?
Yes.
What's up?
Well, I've heard you guys talk a lot about how girls generally don't have orgasms until they're older.
Except we've also said that there's about 10% that have multiple orgasms and have orgasmed terribly easily.
Yeah.
And with every, you know, constantly, and they start at 12 and blah, blah, blah. We talk about the fact that there's this tremendous range in women's response.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, my problem is I'm trying to graduate from college, and so I've been stressed for probably the past, like, 9 months with absolutely no time to have sex with my boyfriend. And so whenever I do
I get the chance to do it, it's five minutes. Shut up. I like when people just sort of steamroll conversationally. Do you guys go to the same college?
Yeah.
This phone system. And here's the comedy. Everyone else can hear the answer.
I know,
but
we
us.
Can't hear it.
Yes. Yeah.
Same college.
You go to the same college. And
Oregon State.
Haven't had time to have sex because you've been... let me just say this. Hold on a second. Now I'm fired up because I didn't get to go to college and I'm bitter about it. But look, everyone does that. Oh, it's stressful. You know, we're coming up, finals. Okay, maybe finals. Maybe you got a midterm or something like that. The rest of the time, that's a vacation compared to what life in the real world is. And shut up, Drew. You got time to have sex with your boyfriend in college. I don't care what's going on, especially the last year. And it's not like if you told me, okay, the last 3 weeks, you got a thesis paper due or something. It's one thing. 9 months, you could handle it. You guys can find a little time, especially if you're living in the same place. Yes? True.
Yes.
A good student, number one, but close second, man of exquisite passion. Yes?
Yes.
Who found time for his passion.
Of course.
Okay. Sorry, Mary. Go ahead.
Oh, I was just wondering, every time we do make love, I orgasm within the first 5 minutes, and then I'm completely done.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And I don't know what I would like to improve that, because then I get the really sad look from him. What do I do?
Yeah, he'd like to improve it, too. He'd like to get you down about 2 minutes. Get back to the TiVo. Wow. All right, that's it. Wait, we get a sad look from him for?
Because I guess he wants to keep going. I don't know what to do.
And you can't go anymore after that.
Why don't you get him more further along before you have the intercourse?
Catch him up. Okay. Give him a little head start,
so to speak.
Head start. Yeah, I might give him a little oral sex. How about that?
I have a jaw problem. I can't do that.
Well, how's your ear?
What?
She has friends.
Yeah. You mean like her hand, or is your, you have a jaw problem? What's wrong with you, MJ?
I can only open my jaw half an inch.
Oh, all right. What's going to do with the other quarter?
What?
Really? Only half an inch?
Yeah, it sucks.
No, it doesn't.
No, it doesn't suck.
Well, shouldn't you get this treated, by the way? And what's
up? I am definitely in the process of getting it treated. It's just a long process, including, like, surgery and braces and everything, so.
Wow. Wow, that's horrible.
Yeah.
I am. Whew. Well, you got to get your, you know what, guy? I'll tell you something guys will go for.
What?
Not me, personally, FYI, ladies, but other guys. Like, I hope Chris's dad isn't listening, but... off the air candidly told me he's a huge fan of this, which a handful of lube and a little work in the right way. Most guys, many guys, I know a lot of guys settle for that. And here's the thing, too, ladies. Yeah, that's an interesting point. I haven't gotten into this in a while. But a lot of you gals think, well, you got to do the oral thing, and maybe you're not so into the oral thing, and you're not into the mess and the whole thing, and fine. Delight your man with a handful of Lubriderm and a vigorous going over.
Not too vigorous.
Not too, but once you get the lube in there, you can actually turn up the RPM just a little bit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, guys, again.
They're fine with that.
Not the Ace Man's cup of tea.
No, but guys are fine.
But I've done a little checking around.
Well, that will certainly, for this purposes of what they're trying to achieve with this situation, and just, again, Mary represents that intermediate zone. There's that zone of women that actually have orgasm with intercourse and or sometimes with oral sex,
mm-hmm.
and it's a single orgasm. It's not the multiple orgasm. She represents about 20, maybe 30% of women.
Yeah. Most guys, I mean, they don't want you to shut down, but I think most guys... would like the idea of being able to, you know, chop that tree down in 5 minutes.
Reliable. I mean,
yeah.
It's like a guy, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Men can understand that. You know what I mean? It makes sense to them.
There's nothing worse than, you know, minute number 23 of you performing a little oral. The chick's been close for 19 and a half minutes.
And a thumper.
Truly, it's like you ever get on like a treadmill and you're just running your ass off and you look down, you've been there for 3 minutes and 22 seconds. You're like, oh, Christ, when is this going to end?
Yeah.
When is this going to end? And someone says, well, we should be going about 30 minutes. And you're thinking, I can't. I'm not even at five. I feel like I'm going to collapse. Okay. It's good times. Cat?
Sleeping? Gone?
Oh, been on hold for 93 minutes. Cat from Wisconsin, 17 years old.
Yep, there you go.
Gay guy friend keeps touching her suggestively. Let me tell you something. I'm hip to you gay guys about that with this too. I've learned. I've seen this time and time again. Gay guys can get away with stuff with chicks that no straight guy could ever get away with. And they do it in a playful way, and they do it in a fun way. And I'm not so sure that the chicks like it, but they always go along with it because they seem really uptight if they don't.
You're suggesting that if a guy should pretend he's gay in high school.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be your strategy now, I'm sure.
I am telling you, I noticed it when I did this ABC show. I had a couple of gay guys over there judging and stuff like that. Gay guy can walk right up to a woman and touch her bosom. And go like, ooh, look at the cleavage on this one. Or, honey, you're stacked. Like,
what?
Gay guys can do whatever they want to chicks. It's awesome. It's an awesome gay power. No, and they dig torturing straight guys with it. You didn't know about this. Let me tell you something. Well, over at the Man Show, we had a gay costumer. And he would grab the juggies. Yeah, look at these. I bet you guys wish you could grab some of these. And he'd come up behind the girls. Well, first off, he would be handling them anyway. You just had to be putting the costumes on and doing. You get to see him naked. When you're gay, you're like a gynecologist with a Miata. That's what you are. You get to do what you want to straight to hot. You know, these models and everything, they're buck naked in front of these guys all the time. You know, oh, please, honey, off of the, oh, please, nothing I haven't seen before. You know, they're just shedding their clothes. They like to screw around with them a little, to grab a little bosom and stuff. They'll taunt the straight guy with it. It's ironically, the gay guy gets the handful of model boob, but you get nothing. And they can make suggestive things. First off, gay guys get away with murder with straight chicks. They really do. It's like, oh, sweet girlfriend, can I tell you? Can I tell you who? Believe me, I'm better at oral than you are. You know, they just do that thing, and they're the chicks will be perceived as totally uptight in like sort of Squaresville if they object to this. Like, oh no, please, I'm uncomfortable with this. Please don't touch my breast. You know, that's weird. Now, straight guy does this, forget about it.
Please,
there's a lawsuit.
Please, yeah.
They call in the SWAT team. Chris's dad come rappelling down a rope.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
All right, so gay guys get away. They get to grab stuff. They do stuff. And I think they show off in front of straight guys. You never seen that, Drew?
No.
Really? Don't know what I'm talking about.
I appreciate what
makes
you're talking
sense.
About. Yeah, never seen it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You got to get out
it
there.
It would be very disturbing.
Huh?
It would be very disturbing.
It's tough when you know they're getting naked and stuff in front of them. And like, oh, what a waste. Look, at cut that guy's eyes out and shove him into my head.
Really?
Yeah, and not where my eyes were, somewhere else. Because I want to keep mine. You know what I mean?
How about your hands? Cut his hands off and put them on your ears or what?
I'm going to need mine for working with wood and scratching
yeah,
and stuff.
Yeah.
I don't try. I want no gay hands. I can't finish my house.
Ah, okay.
See what I'm saying?
Right.
And that's the other thing, too. The gym. Let's just straighten this out, too. The reason the gays are in such immaculate shape, they're at the gym 9 hours a day. They get to look at nude guys.
Oh, yeah, that's all.
Nude
point, yeah.
Dudes. Please, stop pretending like you don't like it. Oh, please, don't flatter yourself. We're not in that. Really? Got a whole stack of honcho magazines underneath your bunk.
Honcho.
Filled with nude dudes. It looked like they've been to the gym. You don't want to go just see a handful of them in real life? Just stop pretending. That's all I'm saying. You know, a gay guy may be gay, but he's a guy first. You see what I'm saying, Drew?
Oh, yeah, I know that about guys.
As a man of passion, you can understand this. Like,
yeah.
Explain this. Like, imagine this as a straight guy. Yeah, you got magazines filled with beautiful, buxom, nubile, naked women. But, yeah, that gym you go to 4 hours a day where you do the communal shower with all the naked women, please don't flatter yourself. And not looking. Not interested. Just got the magazine with them in it. Huh? No one's doing that math? Look, I don't mind the gays checking you out when you're in the shower at the gym. Just admit you're doing it. Get on a better footing. You know what I'm saying?
I hear you. There we go.
Please, don't flatter yourself.
Emily, 21.
Yeah.
5 hours a day at the gym.
What's up?
Drew, remember we used to go to the gym over there?
Oh, yeah.
Nothing but gay guys.
Yep.
All look like Schwarzenegger in his prime.
Yeah.
That's
okay. True.
Yeah, sure. Drew, one last second. What would you look like if you got to go to the West L.A. Bally's and go hang out in the women's locker room?
What would I look like?
Well, I mean, how many hours would you be at that gym every day?
Yeah.
2-3 hours?
Mm-hmm.
You'd be pretty ripped. Every day, hey, it's shower time. Hey, hit the. I'm going to grab a sauna, a schwitz, a shower, and then I'm going to pump iron for another 4 hours, and it's back to take another shower.
You know what, though? Well,
yeah.
Get a little frustrating.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Drew is a man of passion, everybody.
That's right.
You can't tell him to look without touching. That's right. See, me, I just take that home with me.
Oh, my God.
I take them boobies to go. Drew's
in your,
passionate man.
In your
man.
Brain, in your mind.
You, yeah, Drew,
in your
you
memory.
Got it. Yeah. Yes. You got it. You got it. You got it. You eat at the restaurant. You ain't into takeout. Once
yeah,
you smell that
you're not
taking
anything, you're not even taking anything out. You take the memory of the scent.
I'm taking the take home memory. I'm taking the take home menu, and I just look at the picture of the falafel plate and beat off.
That's right.
All right.
What kind of life is that?
Just a damn clean one.
Yeah.
How dare you attack my life and my lifestyle, Emily?
Yeah.
21. What's up?
Hi. I want to know if it's normal to have a low sex drive.
Are you depressed?
No.
Are you on medication?
Yes, I'm on medication, but I was never told
what medication
it interferes or not.
What medication?
Lithobid.
Lithobid doesn't typically do that, but it can.
Is that what Fred Sanford called his dead wife?
It makes me more... that Elizabeth, yes.
Lithobid!
I think that may have more to do with the fact that perhaps you were kind of high before, maybe a little hypomanic, and maybe your sex drive was way up because of being a little manic-y. And now it's kind of brought back down again by the lithobid.
So it's normal for me to not really want to have sex that much.
Well, what's the deal? You got a boyfriend?
Yeah, I have a boyfriend.
You love him?
Yes.
Were you way up high before? Were you wanted it constantly?
Well, with him, I was pretty normal, like maybe wanting it around like four times a week.
Mm-hmm. So if you were dropped down to once a week, twice a week, that would not be abnormal, no.
What?
What are you at now?
Two to three times a week. Or no, yeah. 2 to 3 weeks in between.
Oh. Mm. Yeah. So with this guy, how long have you been with this guy?
A year and a half.
You in love?
Yes.
Okay. Plan on staying with him?
Huh?
You going to stay with him?
Yes.
Okay. And any abuse or anything like that we need to know about?
Nope.
Okay.
Just maybe you're perhaps going off the other side and getting a little depressed from the lithobid. But talk to your doctor about it. I mean, there's ways to adjust these things.
All right. Started his soul off. Had one testicle removed as a baby. Joe?
Yeah?
Had a testicle removed as a baby.
Yeah, when I was 18 months.
You couldn't have just done that handprint in plaster? They had to actually keep a testicle?
See what happened is when it was coming down out of the kidneys, it didn't fully descend down to the scrotum, so it just kind of shriveled and stayed up. And
Your testes don't come from the kidney.
I was going to ask about
they come in the vicinity of the kidney and make their way down in from the abdominal area into the scrotum. And when they don't, they're called a non-descended testy, and the reason they're removed is they can turn into cancer very easily.
Can't they coax them down?
Yeah, they can pull them down sometimes.
Why didn't they?
I don't know. I wish they would have. I kind of miss it.
Yeah.
It's the left one, so...
It's all right. It doesn't mean anything.
But my question
They say the left one controls the right side of the penis, so...
I don't know. But my question was...
Where's that hi-hat?
Imagine how deep his voice would be, by the way, if he had both of them.
Right. No, it actually is the same amount of testosterone. It doesn't make any difference.
All right. You're fine. Does it look weird?
No, it doesn't look weird. I was just wondering if, you know, I can still have kids and everything, and...
Mm-hmm.
Is it still, you know, does it compensate? I never really knew.
How many times do I have to say it doesn't make any difference?
You're fine.
Okay.
Man is built with a certain amount of redundancy, like a jet aircraft that can fly off one engine.
It's possible that both could be non-descended in the process of bringing them down. One gets removed and that doesn't respond normally. But in his case, it sounds like things are fine.
They probably wouldn't have got rid of it if you couldn't have kids. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right.
If you needed both to work, they'd go through pretty extreme measures.
Exactly.
And probably otherwise risking, malpractice suits.
Right.
All right. Is that Okery?
Looks like it. Okery.
Okery? Let's try this. Okery?
Okery, yeah.
Ooh.
The one emphasis we didn't give it, the Okery.
No, I gave it that. I gave the last
you
one.
You tried, yeah.
Wait a minute, I was right.
You said
you were right.
Well, how do you say it?
Okery.
Yeah, there
you go. Say it.
Okery.
No, she said it the same way I said it. I said Okery.
Yep, that's how you said it.
All right, everyone quiet down and listen to me. What's up there, loudmouth?
Hello?
Yeah, what's going on?
Oh, okay. I just want to say you guys are great.
Thanks.
This guy, his name is Ben. And he's 21, and we were friends at the beginning.
Hold on a second. Just because all we have left for Drew and I in the show is to try to settle arguments and amuse ourselves about things like sweetbreads. The guy's name is Fen?
Fed.
Fed.
Fed, yeah, F-E-D.
Oh, boy.
You don't think that might make us pause?
Well, it's all right. You guys make a dynamite confusing couple.
Yeah.
All right, so Fed,
that's what everybody says.
Go ahead.
We were friends at the beginning, and we started to like each other, so we went out. And then during the beginning, he would, you know, occasionally bring me gifts and surprise me at work, and I would do the same. But then towards the middle, he started slacking off. And because I guess once we started having sex, he thought, like, it would be all right not to do anything.
Yeah.
And then after that, I didn't like the way he was treating me either, because everybody else saw that. They thought that it seemed like he had me by the balls, and I didn't see it until I started noticing how he would talk to me, and then I ended it.
Okay.
So then he didn't get mad. He's just like, okay, whatever.
Yeah.
And then after that, we still hung out, so it wasn't awkward at all. And then we started kind of, you know, like touchy-feeling without, you know, saying that we're going out. And then now we turned into buddies, which is...
Okay, what is the matter with this girl?
I'm not sure where she went to finishing school. I'm going to go Milan. I know Drew.
Switzerland.
Drew's Geneva. Thinking Geneva.
Yeah.
There's something, her dialect doesn't sound, it obviously.
Yeah. Yeah,
she could have been Geneva area.
Yeah, I think so.
Let me just. Oh, Kyrie.
Yeah.
Celibate. Geneva or Milan. Where'd you go to finishing school, sweet pea?
I didn't go to neither.
Oh, man. Listen, screwball, you can't use the F word on the radio. Do you understand?
Oh, sorry.
Oh,
shocking, huh? That's a shocking rule, isn't it?
Are you going to junior college yet?
Yeah, to OCC. Yeah.
There you go.
You are. Fantastic.
West Coast College.
Have fun. As a matter of fact, here's what I'd like you to do. I'd like pick out a plot of land where they can bury you there. And by the way, everyone who goes to junior college, you should start scouting out for plots, because that's where they put you in the ground right there. You'll be there for 45 years. They die earlier because they chain smoke over by the snack shack. Uh-huh. And they're just like, my mom's going to be buried at Valley College.
Well, that's nice.
Yeah. They're going to dedicate the auditorium to her. They're going to say, here she stood, row 28, 750 from the left. This is, and did this. Every 10 minutes.
And it'll say good times.
And it'll say good times. Look, I'm mad at her for using the F word. So,
Kyrie, get rid of this guy. He's treating you bad. What the hell? Something's wrong with you, though, that you would pick an abusive guy. So think about that.
Okay. And get out of that junior college.
No.
Get out of that bunker.
She
notice that
belong.
Sand trap. Yeah. Yeah. All right. Listen, stop wasting my tax dollars and your time at this junior college, everybody. Please. Let's go. Let's go. Let's get busy now. You're not students.
Break it down.
You understand? You're not good students. The reason you're going there is because you're crappy students. Stop taking me. Now, listen, that helmet is not a chair. Now, break it down now. Now, get out. Now, get a job. Now, get a vocation, everybody. Get some vocational training and hit the road and start paying some damn taxes. Let's go now. Start being realistic. All right?
Yeah.
All right. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Yeah! Everybody, what is happening?
Yeah.
I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Drew cruising the internet, not listening to the spirited conversation engineer Chris and myself.
Yeah,
having.
It was riveting. We're talking about Chris becoming your houseboy, your ward.
Yeah, I take care of you.
I see you two like Batman and Robin.
Following me around. I'm wearing my house coat and slippers. I've taken to smoking a pipe now. He's following me around, and I'm saying things like, take a note. Take a note. He's got a scratch pad. He's writing stuff down.
I was just...
Yeah?
Just thinking about how your wife's going to like all that.
He loves a good boy.
Yeah.
He's like a young me.
Yeah, she's alone a lot.
Kristen?
Yes.
You're 19?
Yes.
Yes. You have to turn your radio down, please.
Okay, it's down.
Okay, what's up?
Is Adam?
Yes.
Okay, I was just calling because every time a girl sounds even remotely stupid or she says the wrong thing, you ask her if she's in junior college. And that's so terrible because I go to junior college and we're not all stupid.
Hold on. Quiet down.
She's a qualifier, so we're not all stupid.
Hold on 1 second. First off, you said every time a girl does this, probably
more guys than girls.
You think so? Because
I
see you guys like almost every night. Right. It's like every girl's like, hey, are you in junior college?
Well,
you maybe because that's sort of your issue, and so you hear it.
This is a very interesting point, which is when people
All right. People listen to the radio.
Hold on a second. I'm putting her on hold because her line is so effed up. But people hear things, have a certain amount of momentum with it. This is where all the a-hole letter writers of the world come in, and this is why they need to be ignored. She hears me making fun of girls almost exclusively for going to junior college when it's 65-35 guys, maybe 60-40, mainly guys, actually, more so. Lion's share of it is guys.
Yep.
And I'm not saying that to defend myself. It doesn't really matter.
That's the way it is.
It's just the way it is. The last one happened to be a gal, but it's mostly guys. Kristen?
Yeah.
All right. Boy, you got a junior college phone there, too.
I'm sorry. Driving home. I love you guys. I think you're so great.
Thanks, baby doll.
The only thing I was going to say is, it would be so cool if you could give us a little bit of credit every once in a while.
Well, now, wait a minute. He does give credit on certain fronts. One is, A, do you go to nursing school?
No, no.
Uh-oh. Here's what you... Okay, let me... I'll give you my junior college exceptions.
Okay.
Here they go. Here they are. Nursing school. Something very specific. You're not there for general education. You're there to get whatever that degree you need to get your nursing certificate.
RN.
RN. That's your degree. You get an RN degree, or you become an RN?
You get an RN.
They call it an RN
There's
degree?
There's a BSRN. There's a bachelor's degree in nursing, but it's RN.
So you go in there specifically going for something.
Yeah.
Number two, crazy nationalities moved in this country. You were like a doctor wherever you were. You came here. You got to bone up for the boards. Yeah. Fine. There's that. There's the almost any nationality I'll take. Yeah, I'll take almost anyone that comes to this country has got to get their bearings straight.
You have to be new to the country. We accept
be
any
nice.
Nationality.
Now, be nice to be new to the country.
How many months?
You got,
or
if
years?
You're third generation Korean, you got no excuse.
Okay. Well, your parents kill yourself, but
you got to come here. Yeah, your parents kill themselves too. If you're third, you need to go to junior college. Okay. So crazy nationalities that come here from other countries.
Yeah.
Fine. Nursing school students, and then what I like to call then you got your athletes. Mm-hmm. It's just your stupid guy who couldn't make the grades, but he's a phenomenal basketball player, football player, he's looking to transfer.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. And then what I like to call your hard luck cases. This is the guy whose dad got pancreatic cancer his senior year of high school and had to drop out to basically go home and take care of the guy.
So he's getting caught up.
He's getting caught up in pushback.
Yeah.
His dream got delayed
diverted,
because of he got into a skiing accident, a motorcycle accident. Something happened.
Yeah.
Tragedy.
Yeah.
He'll be back on track in another 10 months.
Yeah.
There's that guy. The rest of you're just crappy students.
Yeah.
And now you're like taffy. You're stretching this dream out so you can live at home for another 5 years. And then you got your extreme cases. You got my buddy John, who's now 40 and still going over to L.A. Junior College. You got people like my mom, who was going there until she was in her 50s. This becomes a way for society not to bother you. Now, here's the thing. If you're a 40-year-old guy and you've chosen not to work, society comes down on you. Okay, what are you doing? Chilling, hanging out. Hey, buddy, what's up? What are you, loser? Why don't you get your ass together? But you can go to college. I'm going on to college. Oh, okay, that's great. Yeah, I'm doing some studying. I think it's, you're trying to further your education. That's fantastic. It's a way to get society off your back.
Mm.
I'm saying society should, unless you meet the criteria. Wacky nationality, nursing student.
Right.
Now, if you show me a combination, you show me a Nigerian guy who's a star on the track team and trying to get his nursing certificate and transfer to UCLA on a track scholarship. Nah, that kid's cool. And his dad died in a civil war.
Oh, there you go.
Nigerian civil war just a few
that
years.
Kid's a hero.
He's in.
That's just cool.
He's golden. He's golden. All right. Stephanie?
Uh-huh.
You're 23?
Do what?
You're 23?
Yeah.
What's up?
So I've been on birth control for 12 years.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just wondering, this last year I've had more problems with it than anything else, and I'm wondering if becoming ineffective or
what do you mean there's a problem?
Well, like I would say the last year I've had problems like just bleeding like nonstop. The past 3 weeks have been the worst. I have a different partner and I've been tested for everything, but and I've been on like the same pill, like I said, for 12 years, and I'm just wondering if that's wearing off, if I should try something else.
No, the bleeding has nothing to do with its effectiveness.
You?
Nothing.
Same pills since you were 11?
Yeah.
Why'd you go on when you were 11?
I was having problems. I'd bleed for like 6 months at a time.
Okay, so you've got irregular periods. You already
know right.
that kind of thing. So you're prone to this. So it's not about the pill. It's about you.
Well, then I'm worried because I've been on it, and they changed it from orthocycline to orthotricycline, and then just recently...
Wait a minute. You haven't been on the same pill. It's a completely different pill.
Well, I mean, like, it switched probably when I was in college, which was about 4 or 5 years ago.
That's
so I've been on orthotricycline.
So it
hasn't changed anything yet.
You've been on the same pill the whole time except for half the time.
You've been on
or two-thirds of the time you're on another pill.
I just figured they were kind of similar. Well, now
no,
my doctor's trying to put me back on orthocycline again.
Right.
And I'm wondering, well, why would... I mean, I thought that...
You'll stop bleeding. He'll stop bleeding. Stephanie, oh boy. Junior college? What do you think?
Oh, true. Come on. You know, I don't go there. Stephanie?
Huh?
Junior college?
No, I went to a university and got a bachelor's degree.
And
wow.
In junior college?
You got to get your money back. Where'd you go? In Arizona?
No, I went to New Mexico State. It's in Las Cruces, New Mexico.
Wow. What'd you get your degree in?
Hotel, restaurant, tourism management.
Oh. Are those the Lobos or something?
They're the Aggies.
The Aggies. Who are the Lobos?
University of New Mexico.
Lobos are Albuquerque, UNM.
Oh, I see. All right.
Look, the monophasic pill, the orthocycline, will probably stabilize things. Yes, you need to get on a different dose of estrogen, progesterone. You need to try some different things. The bleeding can have different meanings. Hopefully they're evaluating you for other things like thyroid conditions and whatnot to be sure there's not something else going on, but usually just a matter of finding a different dose pill. And if you were stable before on the single dose, the monophasic, then you go back to that.
Mm-hmm.
That's it, period. Intracycle bleeding, mid-cycle bleeding is part of being on the pill.
Mm-hmm. Hey, can we call something other than bleeding? You know, we got to figure a period up and bleed. Let's get that. Like, for instance, I like spotting.
Yeah,
I like
mid-cycle
that.
Spotting.
Mid-cycle spotting, I'm cool with that. I'm trying to think of some sort of euphemistic yet appropriate term for bleeding. It always gives me a little...
Leaking?
I get kittens in my stomach when I hear about the bleeding. I'm feeling like in flow is tough, too. Everything's just... All the euphemistic stuff always bothers
Sloughing?
Me now, too. Sloughing.
Mid-cycle sloughing? Sloughage?
Because is that really what... That's really what's going on, right?
Yeah, the uterine lining is sloughing.
All right. Let's go with sloughing.
Neil.
Yeah.
You're 25?
Yes, sir.
What's up?
Well, me and my girl, we've been together for about 6 years. And for the past, like, 5 years, we've been trying to have a kid without any success.
Mm.
You've been dating how long?
We've been dating for 6 years. But
5 years. And she's how old now?
I'm 25.
She's how old now?
I'm 25.
Should I ask her
again? Let me try. He's how old now?
I'm 25 years old.
Oh, that didn't work.
I'm on a cell phone.
Oh, okay. Your girlfriend is how old?
Oh, she's 30.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so she's having fertility problems, as women frequently do when they get into their 30s.
She's had children before.
Right, and now she's getting older, and now she's starting to have fertility problems, as women frequently do as they get into their 30s.
But in her 30s, she's 30. Mm-hmm. She's had 3 kids.
Yeah.
Yeah? Fertility problems?
Aging, yeah.
That does
aging,
it.
Aging, yeah.
Even 30.
At 40, it's over, pretty much.
I know, but that's
for
10
some women,
years from 30.
For some women, 30, they drop off. 35, they drop off a lot.
We've been trying to have kids since she was 26.
Well, that's a good point, too.
Mm-hmm. She's been
going at it for mm-hmm. a while.
So have you been tested to make sure you're okay?
That's what I was asking. How do I go about that?
You go. You talk to her gynecologist about it.
Really? About him?
Yeah.
That's okay.
Well, they may send you to a fertility doctor, but...
Yeah. It could be you, Neil.
That's what I'm thinking, because when I was younger, I had a real bad infection in my foot, and I was given anabolic steroids to rebuild the tissue that I had lost.
No. That's probably not it. But anyway, you guys have been going... How old are her kids, by the way?
She has 8, 5 and a 6-year-old.
And does
really he need to have another kid?
Well, I think, and you know, and I can kind of understand this, even though I, you know, as a radio show host, I would like to get up on my high horse here, but he doesn't feel like those are quite his kids.
Well, get over it. He signed on for this.
Well, I mean, Neil, that is, you know, a good question, which is 3 kids, especially 8, 5, and 6, that seems like a handful.
Well, she doesn't have them. Her ex-husband has them.
Oh.
Ooh. Ooh.
Where's he live?
He lives in Anaheim.
Uh-huh.
That's where she lives.
Does she see the kids a lot?
Oh, yeah.
What's the matter with her that she lost custody?
We go down and see the kids together and stuff. She goes see them.
What's the matter with her that she lost custody?
She just wasn't in a stable home at the time. And she wasn't making enough money to support the kids.
She was the home. What's the matter with her that she lost custody of her kids?
She just didn't. She at the time,
Neil,
her and her husband weren't getting along. I think.
Hey, Neil, what are you talking about? The husband would be supporting the kids. They stay with the mom. Why did she lose custody? That must have been some very, very egregious problem that she had.
Was she doing drugs?
No. She doesn't do any drugs. I mean, the only thing she does is smoke.
All right. Did the husband remarry?
Yes, he did.
I mean, there is occasion where the dad remarries, makes a good living, and says, look, I want to start the thing. And it's there, the mom's like, all right, you got a better situation.
But that's after a while. It's not right at the beginning.
Has he had the kids since the divorce?
No. Oh. For the first, they have, like, joint custody.
Okay.
All right. It's, like, it's 60,
making
40.
All right, making more sense now. All right, go to the fertility specialist.
There you go.
And, Drew, you went to one, yes?
Absolutely.
I actually went to one, too.
No way.
For a man show bit.
Oh, yeah.
Beat off right into a cup.
Did you have the little room they send you to and you hand across to the lab techs?
We timed it.
Oh, that's right, you and Jimmy were racing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One other thing that's bizarre?
Huh.
I'll tell you, I can give myself credit here.
No.
First off, it was a race to see who could produce a sample the fastest, me or Jimmy.
Yeah.
I won.
Nice.
I beat Jimmy. Now, here's the interesting thing. It was a race, and, I'm a competitive guy.
Yeah.
I, like a good deodorant commercial, I'll give 110% to just about everything I do, even if it's beating off competitively. I beat Jimmy, pardon the pun, in the race. But here's the deal. I came bursting out of the room. I had my pants around my ankles. Jimmy had put himself back together and burst out of the room about 5 seconds later.
Oh.
So if you sort of factor in the time it took him to pull his pants up and re-buckle his belt, probably came within about a second and a half,
so to speak,
of each other. And that time, 2:18.
Whew.
Whew. From the time it went running into the room.
That's crazy.
That's mic'd up with a female director standing out in the hall with a camera crew. Talk about concentration.
Ninja.
I'm a pro.
Ninja.
I'm a pro. All right. Let's take ourselves a little break. We'll be right back after this. Hey, buddy. LoveLine. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Let's go now.
Break it down.
Let's break it down, everybody. Let's get a hand in now. Remember, that helmet? It's not a chair, gentlemen. And when I say gentlemen, I use that term loosely. Come on, ladies. Gather around. All right. Let's go to the phones now. What do you say, Drew?
Let's go.
7:22 Speak to Candace. Candace, hot name. That's a hot chick name. You hear Candace. Hey, you got a blind date? What's her name? Candace?
Mm. Hello?
Candace? What's up?
Okay. Well, I was on birth control pills prior, and now I've been prescribed the patch by
basically a random doctor, and I had problems with the pill before, and I wanted to know if the patch would do the same thing, if it would make me sick and moody and cause swelling and water retention and make me really just
Those are all basically the estrogen effects of the pill. So any moderate dose, presumably that's the pill that made you sort of goofy before, will do that again, anything with moderate amounts of estrogen. You may need to be on a low-dose estrogen pill.
Okay, what would that be? Because I don't even know. I don't want to get pregnant, but
there's a bunch of those now. LoveLine or set. There's a bunch of them. But you have to talk to your doctor about that. You can try the patch. See if that works. But if it doesn't, I switch to a low dose pill.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
All right.
Okay. Bye.
All right.
Yeah. Here we go. Break it down.
Oh my God. I'm reading this copy they want me to do for this crappy Playboy commercial. Who writes these things?
It's a trial. It's a pretend.
Who?
I know.
Who writes this?
Don't do that. Don't torture yourself. Lena, what's up?
Hello?
Hi.
Hi, my name's Lena.
Yeah.
My husband has a sore on his penis. It's like kind of like a blister, and the skin's been kind of taken off.
Mm-hmm.
And, hello?
Yep.
Hello.
Oh, sorry. Hi, and my girlfriend, or my husband and our girlfriend are here, and we want to have sex tonight, but we want to use a condom, and I want to make sure that the lubrication in the condom isn't going to irritate that.
Who wants to have sex? And by the way, last night when I got home, I was watching a movie with Lena Olson, Olin, in it, and I thought, oh, that's a cool name, Lena.
Oh, right on.
Yeah.
We never had a call named Lena.
Never, but less than 24 hours ago, I was just sitting drinking my red wine thinking, Lena, that's a neat name.
Oh, that's
name.
Cool. Lena. Yeah. Right on.
Lena Olin, by the way, is a nice combo 1-2 name. All right, so you got a hot chick, too. You have your husband and there's another girl?
And our girlfriend, yeah.
And you guys want to get it on?
Yeah, but I just don't want to hurt him. You know, I don't want the condom to, infect it or something. You know what I mean?
Yeah, well,
condom's not going to affect it.
No, it's not going to affect
saying
it.
That Band-Aid's going to infect
right.
the cut.
It is, however, the latex leaning against it is going to sting.
Yeah,
and the problem is here.
Small
this
price to pay for the threesome.
How do you know this isn't herpes or even syphilis?
Oh, no, we've all been tested. We make sure that everything's, completely, kosher and all that.
You've had viral cultures for herpes without an outbreak?
Yes.
No, you haven't had that.
Well, but this guy's worn the skin off his dork from the constant pounding he's giving Lena and her gal pal.
Okay, well, not exactly from that, but okay.
All right.
So this could be herpes, right?
Huh?
How could this not? What makes you think this isn't herpes?
Because it's from from him masturbating too much.
Hold on a second. First off, as my buddy Clint Eastwood would say, man's got to know his own limitations.
Yeah.
I mean, I like beating off, but even I don't punch holes in my skin. Secondly, that's a fairly convenient... hold on.
Excuse.
Yeah, if you're bringing up sores because you're beating off too much, you belong in a ward somewhere.
And you have two women ready to go.
This guy's no rookie. This ain't some 13-year-old at Jewish camp.
Right.
This guy's a seasoned beat-off veteran.
Right.
If he's drawing blood, he's either got a psychiatric condition or he's full of ass.
Right.
Get back to Lena.
You're outraged.
I'm outraged. Lena? Yeah. How big a gal are you?
Me?
Yeah.
Not huge, not big girl. I mean, I'm not, fat or anything. That's what you're saying.
What do you got? What are you coming in at?
Hmm?
What are you weighing in at?
What am I weighing? I can tell you what I weigh. Mm-hmm. Tell America what I weigh.
Let's see. I got you at 153.
Close to that.
Yeah. Yeah, make it 161.
Are you saying I'm fat?
No. I just
checking.
I'm just going to combine this up over 3 bells.
Okay.
With the two ladies?
Okay.
All right. It makes me feel better.
All right.
It really will.
Okay.
It really
does. Does that make you really feel better?
It really does.
Okay.
It's going to get me through the night. So here's the thing. Yes, this could be herpes. I don't believe this guy is beating off too much. He's got a sore.
It was just this week. It's a weak thing.
Bogus.
I don't know. And what's he using? Rock salt?
Yeah.
Is he beating off with?
Yeah, bogus.
They're bogus?
Hmm.
No. I don't think bogus. She had that threesome chick
craziness. She had that going.
Yeah, it's crazy meets anger meets sort of
bravado.
Condescending.
Yeah, yeah, bravado, yeah.
Yeah, aloof. Yeah. Okay. All right, put the condom on.
Yes.
What do he wants to say? He's got an open wound on his pecker.
Yeah.
You guys going to wave that polluted wand all over your party?
Right, we'd say don't have sex, really, if you want to be extra careful. Even if people are known to have herpes, it's suggested that they not have sex even with a
condom. What about this? If I had an outbreak, I would have them work one side of my penis.
Hmm.
Like two chicks
one side.
On this quadrant. You just work this quarter. Just that quarter, left side next to the sack, ladies.
Corner pocket.
All right. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Hey, everybody.
Hey, everybody.
It's the show. All right, there.
It's the end of the show gibberish, too.
Hey, Jay Moore coming in here. Yeah.
He's got that's a big deal. The starring in a film.
Yeah. He's done some substantial work, that kid, you know? Mm-hmm. Not the kind of movies you've done, Drew.
No, nothing like that.
I don't think he's worked with the Olsen twins.
No.
We're going to take ourselves a little extendo break. And like I said, Jay Moore tomorrow night. So, until next time, this is Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew saying mahalo. Gay guys can do whatever they want to chicks. It's awesome.
This has been LoveLine. The opinions expressed on this show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station. The producer for LoveLine is Ann Ingold. LoveLine is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.